Patty Lee, and you are watching another Patty Lee TV production. I am here with Sister Anna Cardona from Congregation Lion of Judah. Thank you so much for joining me. Yes.
Thank you for inviting me.
Yes, thank you. And I am so excited to be here again, because I used to be here on Boston Praise Radio Monday through Sunday, I think. And this has initiated me into learning about more about media, about taking the airwaves violently for God, for His kingdom and His Christ. And the name of this program is Fruitful in My Affliction. And the reason I named that the program Fruitful in My Affliction is because of Psalm 119:72. David learned that he didn't go astray because he started to have a more of an understanding of his statutes. But with that, I want to ask Sister Anna if you could open us in prayer. And I just want to let everyone know that we're multilingual here. So, Sister Anna, if you could pray.
Amen. Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, Señor, venimos delante de tu presencia, Señor, dándote a ti la gloria, Señor, la honra. Padre amado, Señor, presentándote esta participación, Señor, en este momento, que usted nos dé gracia, tu favor, que nos guíe, Señor, en todo lo que vamos a hacer en este tiempo, Señor. Te presento a la hermana Patricia, el pastor, y todo lo que se va a hacer en este tiempo, Señor, que sea usted dirigiendo, tomando el dominio y control, Padre. Padre amado, que manifieste su gloria y tu poder, Señor. Que sea usted, Señor, tomando todo dominio, Espíritu Santo, dirigiéndonos, poniendo la palabra, Señor, en el nombre de Jesús. Cubre los aires, Señor, con tu sangre, con tu misericordia, Padre. Toma todo dominio, Espíritu Santo. Todo dominio te pertenece. Oh, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Father, Lord, take dominion in everything that we're going to do in this time, Padre, in the name of Jesus. Father, mm-hmm. Lord. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father. Yes, te ponemos todo en tus manos, Señor, que sea usted glorificándote, Señor, dirigiéndonos, Señor, tomando todo control, Padre, por el poder de tu palabra, Señor, por la sangre del Cordero, Señor, que fue derramada en aquella cruz del Calvario. Padre, Señor, Padre, y abre los oídos espirituales, Señor, de aquellos que están escuchando en esta hora, Padre, y que usted sea tocando los corazones, Señor, manifestándote tu gloria y tu poder, Señor. Padre, en el nombre de Jesús. Jesús, cubre este vecindario en esta hora, Señor. Llega a esa vida, Señor, en el nombre de Jesús, que te necesita. Oh, Señor, esas almas, Padre, que no se pierdan, Padre. Oh, sí, Señor, en el name of Jesus, Father, Lord. Padre, que sea usted tomando, Señor, dominio y control, Señor. Manifiesta tu gloria y tu poder. En el name of Jesus, Señor. Dirígenos y pon la palabra en nuestra boca, Padre. Para aquella palabra que necesitan los que están escuchando en esta hora, Señor, en el nombre de Jesús.
Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 And I'd also like to lift a prayer for Pastor Bruce Wall. I just thank you, Father God, for Pastor Bruce Wall, for Pastor Karen Wall, for all the ministers that come and enter into this room, Father God. I thank you, Lord, that the blood of Jesus cover them from the crowns of their head to the soles of their feet, Father God. And as they speak your word, Father, that yokes would be broken, Lord, in the name of Jesus, and that they would call on the yoke breaker Jesus Christ, and that those yokes would be broken in the name of Jesus, that they would call on God and say, oh God, let our God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let our God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Every enemy of racism, let them be scattered. The strong man of violence, let you be scattered right now in the name of Jesus Christ. You have no place in this city of Boston, and we take our dominion and we take our authority over you in the name of Jesus Christ. Every demonic system, every institution, the blood of Jesus be against you right now in the name of Jesus. Those things that have held our community in chains, too long. Let you yes. be bound now in the name of Jesus. We command you to cease and desist. Sí, we command you to leave in the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you, Father God, that you set them up and you put them down, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, that you set, Father God, good righteous people up, Father God, so that people will rejoice and be glad in this city of Boston and surrounding areas, Father God, that it would be good for everyone to be in this city, Father God, regardless of race, regardless of creed, Father God, but let your righteous people stand up, get up in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And I thank you, Father God, that you would empower them, Father God, to do what you have called them to do. The purpose, the plan that you've preordained and predestined them, Lord. Father God, what you've called them to do, Father, we call them forth now by divine authority in the name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you for them, God, that you tie them with bands of love, oh God. Thank you, we thank you, Father God, and let every spirit be subject to the Holy Spirit here in the city of Boston, Father God, as we stand up and get up, Father God, taking territory for you and for your kingdom and your Christ, oh God. We thank you, Father God. Yes, glorify yourself in this city of Boston, oh God. Use the men and women of God, Father God. Oh God, we thank you for the fivefold
and dominion,
manifold, the fivefold ministry here in Boston. Use them, Father, like only you can. Cover them, oh God, with the blood of Jesus Christ, Father, that they wouldn't go to the left or to the right. And I thank you, Father God, that they would encourage each other, that they would exhort each other, that they would sing psalms, Father God. And I thank you, Father God, for your living word that lives in and through them, oh God. That they would be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit with fire.
Yes.
Fall on them now and encourage them. Ignite in them a fire, a zeal, a passion for you, oh God. That without you they wouldn't move to do the things of God. And I thank you, Father God. I thank you for the children of the city of Boston, Father God. That the blood of Jesus cover the children of the city of Boston, oh God.
Lord, in the name
Father
of
God,
Jesus,
I speak life. And I declare life, Father God, and not death in their life, in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus be against every enemy of God. The bloodthirsty spirit after them, Father God. The blood of Jesus be against them right now in the name of Jesus. And we declare them, Father God, for your kingdom and your Christ. Every soul of children, Father God, that they would know the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ, Father God. We claim them for you and your kingdom, oh God. I thank you, Father God, that the King of glory would come in, oh God. I thank you, Father God. Have your way and have your will here in this city of Boston, oh God. And I thank you, Father God, that your word and it goes and it performs what it was sent to do. It doesn't fall to the ground, but it goes and it performs what it was sent to do. Not because of what I say, but it's because of what you say. It's what you commanded, Father God. And I thank you that you've given us power and authority, Father God, to tread upon serpents and scorpions, Father God. I thank you that there be no serpents or scorpions in this city, Father God. We command, Father God, a blessing over this city in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I just thank you, Father God. I thank you for what you're doing in and through the body of Christ. I thank you, Father God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
And I thank you, Father God, for your Ana Cardona. Mm-hmm. Could you explain a little bit, or si quieres en español también, si puedes explicar un poquito sobre la línea que tiene de teléfono de oración?
Amén. Yo lo explico y tú lo dices en inglés.
Okay.
Well, I remember that I was praying in the middle of the night, the Lord, you know, I mean, I'm going to say Spanish.
Okay.
I'm sorry. Yo me recuerdo que estaba durmiendo. El Espíritu Santo me levantó.
She was sleeping. The Holy Spirit woke her up.
That was on 2014.
That was in 2014.
In April.
You speak in English.
Yeah.
En abril.
Y el Espíritu Santo me levantó. Entonces, eran las 2 de la mañana.
It was 2 a.m.
Y ese día el Espíritu Santo me llevó de rodillas hasta mi ventana. Mi ventana queda enfrente del el Prudential, todos esos buildings que están ahí de Prudential. That's my view.
The Holy Spirit brought her to kneel towards a window in her home, towards the Prudential.
Yeah. Y el Espíritu Santo empezó a gemir dentro de mí.
And so she started to have intercession with moans and groans through the Holy Spirit.
El Espíritu Santo empezó a gemir y a hablar en lenguas.
And so she started speaking in tongues.
Y el Espíritu Santo y el Señor me decía que él iba a destruir todo. Él me decía, dile a mi pueblo.
And the Holy Spirit said, tell my people.
Que él iba a destruir todo.
That he would destroy everything.
Y esa noche solamente eso, yo empecé a temblar mi cuerpo. Fue un tiempo bien especial para mí porque me sentí bien cerca del Señor.
And it was a special time for me because I felt very close to the Lord.
Y ahí yo entendí que el Señor quería que oráramos, porque cuando el Señor muestra algo es porque quiere que el pueblo ore.
So she understood that because she had this vision, the Lord was impressing upon her that the people of God need to pray.
So yo no tenía internet.
I didn't have the internet.
Y tampoco sabía, o sea, no podía entrar en mi teléfono.
And I couldn't go on my phone.
Pero Dios me dio solamente 2 minutos.
He gave me only 2 minutes.
En mi teléfono, yo pude hacer la aplicación de Lion Prayer.
And she could get into Lion Prayer.
So yo hice la aplicación.
So she downloaded the application.
El Señor, tú sabes, me dio los números y ahí empezó.
And gave her the numbers.
Ahí empezó la línea de oración.
And that's how I initiated the Holy Spirit initiated.
Pero
the
yo
prayer
sentí
line.
Que era del Señor porque después de eso no he podido entrar en el teléfono, tú sabes, en el internet.
And so, but after that, she believes that she was led of the Holy Spirit because she couldn't go on to the internet.
So, y así comenzamos esta línea de oración.
So that's how we started the prayer line.
Y estamos orando, tenemos esta línea de oración de el ciento del Señor que quiere 24 horas de oración.
She believes that the Lord is impressing a 24-hour prayer line.
Ahora mismo estamos cubriendo solamente 5 de la mañana.
We are only covering 5 a.m.
3 de la mañana.
3 a.m.
1 de la de 1 a 2 de la tarde.
1 to 2 in the afternoon.
Y de 8 a 9 de la noche.
And 8 to 9 at night.
So necesitamos personas que quieran, guerreros que quieran entrar y pelear esta batalla. Esta batalla no es de nosotros, es del Señor.
And we are looking for people that would like to take hours on the prayer line. And that are prayer warriors, and this is not of us, it is of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Y hasta aquí pues estamos esto, orando, seguimos orando, la lucha no es fácil.
We continue to pray, and the battle is not easy.
Pero Dios tiene el control y Él nos da la fuerza y la fortaleza.
But the battle is the Lord's, and He gives us the strength to fight.
Amen.
Amen, amen. So for me, I know that I met Anna, it'll be 8 years ago that I've been born again. Mm-hmm. And 2014, we both had the opportunity to go to Israel.
Yes.
And what a beautiful time, huh?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. And that's when you invited me to start praying with you
guys. Yes, mm-hmm. I want to go back to Israel, but that's not the
point. No, sigue, yes. Si quiere hablar.
Ese viaje de Israel fue muy impresionante para mí. Fue algo muy lindo, muy bonito. Y a través de la línea de oración, lloré 90 días para este viaje.
She prayed 90 days for this trip.
Y el Señor me lo concedió que fui standby.
And the Lord gave her the trip because she was on standby.
Solamente pagué por el hotel, no
pagué
por
el. And she only paid for the hotel.
Y fue muy interesante porque cuando habían 2 semanas que ya íbamos a ir al viaje.
And when it was very interesting because 2 weeks before the trip,
las personas empezaron a llamarme, decirme, ¿cómo tú vas a ir con la cosa que están pasando allá?
And people started calling me like, how are you going to go over there with the things that are going on there?
Es peligroso ir para allá.
It's very dangerous to go.
Yo empecé a desanimarme.
And then I felt discouraged.
Y hasta mi madre me llamó. Y me
Even dijo, my mother tried to discourage me.
Y yo me desanimé, sí, pero...
And I was discouraged.
Yo llamé a una persona que tiene mucha intimidad con el Señor, que yo lo conozco.
And I called somebody that's very intimate with the Lord.
Y solamente le dije, ora por mí, necesito una respuesta del Señor, nada más.
And then I just prayed, I asked him, pray for me, I just need an answer from the Lord.
That's the only thing I said to him. Y él empezó a orar por mí.
And he started praying for me.
Y cuando él empezó, él me dice, este viaje es mío. El Señor te dice, este viaje es mío, te llevo y te traigo, te enseñaré cosas. Te voy a enseñar cosas allá. Entonces, y empezó a hablarme así que el viaje era del Señor. Y ahí me animé y me fui.
And so he didn't know anything about the trip, but he said, his words were, this is of the Lord, you're going to go and come back, and I'm going to make it all possible.
Yeah, and he said, that field trip is mine. I take you there, and I'm going to bring you back. I'm going to show you things that you never, I'm going to show you.
Things that you've never seen.
Yeah.
Amen.
And it was beautiful over there. I just want to go back. I want to stay over there. So beautiful.
Amen. So nice. Amen. Beautiful. Yeah. And so I've had the opportunity to pray off and on with you at 5 a.m.
Yes.
Which has been a blessing to me. And I praise God for you because I was very discouraged and I didn't want to go because I was having a spiritual warfare with my son. Mm-hmm. When the enemy can't attack us directly, he'll try to attack the people that are around us. And my son was really going through a lot. And I remember you would say, nope, don't be discouraged. Don't stay behind. Come on, let's go. Pray for him and leave it in God's hands and trust him. And I can say today, my son asked me to pray with him.
Amen.
You know, the other day, he was counting his blessings. I was like, wow, God, you're awesome.
Amen.
Because I could never tell him how to walk and talk with God. You know, I could have never done that.
Beautiful.
So I see that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
And the word of our testimony. And we
Amen.
Don't love our life until the death.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to do sometimes things that our flesh don't want to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and this whole walk with God has been extraordinary. And I was thinking about how, you know, I was saying to myself, God, you know, I was 2 weeks ago very angry with God and didn't realize that I had unforgiveness with God. And I went to Lion of Judah to a conference that they had. And here I go crying. I'm going to always be a crier, I think. I don't know if that'll ever leave me. I was a cry baby. And
good.
I'm laughing and crying at the same time. This is Patty. live and direct. Vivo y directo, estamos aquí. And you know, I was saying through so many different afflictions when I was little, the abuse, the physical abuse that was extreme, and then the physical abuse that was extreme when I was a young adult, and facing so many trials. And I was saying, God, you know, why so much pain? You know, I was asking the wrong things, you know, but you don't understand when you're going through it. And then when I lost my son, like now I look at it and I say, it was good that I was afflicted, you know, because I might not have been able to withstand the loss of my son.
Yes.
So it's like he's been like toughening me up so that I could deal with this, you know?
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
And I say, well, you know, I guess I died to myself and I died to my life so that Christ can really be revealed through me.
Amen.
Because I have to look at God gave his only son for me. A sinner, you know, a mess, crazy in my stuff. Ooh, Lord, running rampant. And even while I am with the Lord, you know, dealing with a lot of the after effects of a life of damage and brokenness, you know. But what can his blood do, you know, and just the healing and the things that he can do in restoring. Excuse me. And I was saying to myself, wow, look at what God can do. You know, and I've taken this, I can't probably even see right now, this scripture really to heart in Psalm 119 in verse 72. It says, the law from your mouth is more precious to me than thousands of pieces of silver and gold. Yes. Your hands made me. Informed me. Give me understanding to learn your commands. May those who fear you rejoice when they see me, for I have put my hope in your word. I know, O Lord, that your laws are righteous, and in faithfulness you have afflicted me. So, you know, we don't understand why we're being afflicted. And we don't understand the pains that we go through.
Yes.
And so that's why I call this program Fruitful in My Affliction. You know, I'm learning to walk and talk with him, right? And yesterday I was saying to myself, you know, I don't know how God, a certain thing is going to pan out. But when I was going to that Holy Ghost encounter, I was with a sister and a man was walking up and he was singing, Just Ask the Lord. And I was like, that really bugged me out. So I was like, God, you know, I have this bill that I got to pay. You know, he's saying ask him. So I'm like, God, I need you to show up. So I paid the bill, you know, and I was saying to myself, I don't know how XYZ is going to happen, but you know, I got to do this. And then yesterday, I just felt like, conforme, like I'm okay. No, it was actually a hard day because I went to an addiction and recovery program. They were showing how the jail system is set up for us to lose, you know. But my God rules and reigns in this city, and I'm dreaming to see our people free. And I know that it will come true because that's his word. It's not mine.
Yes.
And so then I was feeling kind of down, and then I went home, and I couldn't believe, listen, to the it's right here. I got a check in the mail that I wasn't expecting. And it's the bill he gave me to the dollar. I said, wow. I said, that's God. And so then it was like, I named the program Fruitful in My Affliction. And then I go home and I got a check in the mail. I said, only that's my God. Only my God. Oh, no, I left it upstairs. I wanted to show it. But I said, wow, my God is so real. You know, so when you're talking about how we need to pray, you know, that's a beautiful thing because we're at the throne room of God, you know. So I don't know if you want to say anything to that.
Also, the other day, I wasn't expecting a check either. I had this, tengo este banco, Soviet Bank.
She has a bank.
Soviet Bank. I closed my account like 2 years ago or last year, I don't know. And last Friday, they sent me a check for $245.
Glory to God.
And I said, I couldn't believe it. I said, no, this is
right.
But I said, it's my name. I'm just going to go deposit. But I don't know. I didn't expect that either. So God worked the way he just wanted, you know. Él trabaja como él quiere. Él se glorifica como él quiere.
He glorifies himself the way he wants.
Y él conoce cada necesidad, cada persona, ¿verdad?
Amen.
Y le estamos orando porque que él abra las puertas de los cielos a favor.
That he opens the doors of heaven.
A favor de sus siervos.
For the favor of his servants.
Yeah. Y estamos orando para que el Señor supla las necesidades de cada del pueblo de Dios.
And we're praying that he would supply all of our needs according to his riches and glory. I'm going to throw stuff in his word. But if you do have a prayer request, and if you have a financial need, and you need a breakthrough, and you want to call, we would love to pray with you. The number here is 617-282-0685. My name is Patty Lee, and I'm here with Sister Anna Cardona and the Body of Christ. And we're just here setting our heads like flint and believing God for what he has said.
Amen.
And I actually want to thank Anna's Pro Cleaning, because in part, this program is brought to you by them. And so we're still working out some of the quirks, and I praise God for Pastor Wall, who is such a techie. And hallelujah for the techies and the people that are making this possible, you know, because
Amen.
This is a blessing to us. We do need to take the airwaves by force for his kingdom and for his Christ.
Amen.
So I'm going to play Anna's Pro Cleaning. If you ever need any kind of cleaning services. I don't know, I can't.
Your settings. Anna's Pro Cleaning Service mission is to offer excellent service and quality in cleaning, maintenance, and snow removal across a variety of settings, like commercial establishments, residences, and construction sites. Anna's Pro Cleaning aims to meet the unique needs of each client, inspiring a sense of well-being in their environment. We also care deeply about our employees, offering meaningful growth opportunities.
So Anna's Pro Cleaning Services, you can actually call them, and I am going to give you the number right now. It is, sorry. I don't know why I can't see this. 781-251-0700. And they actually do snow removal, they do interior cleaning, exterior cleaning, deep cleaning. Give them a call. They're reliable mom and pop shop kind of a business in our community. And I'm a strong believer in helping each other in our businesses, you know, because we need each other. And I'd also like to thank Ms. Mo from excuse me, Mohasa. She is located on 1855 Washington Street in the South End, and she's always hooking a sister's hair up. I'm very, very happy with her. And it's convenient, you know, it's a nice location. She's also a believer. And I mean, she takes care of me, and she takes care of the salon. You could tell she loves what she does. And I don't really like people like on my head. So, but she's at 1855 Washington Street in Boston South End. She's open Tuesday through Saturday. And I thank God for her. And that's it with the announcements for now. And you are listening to 102.9 FM, Boston Praise Radio and TV. My name is Patty Lee. I am the host of Patty Lee TV Productions. And this program is based on Psalm 119:72. And I am fruitful in my affliction. And I'm glad that he even gave me fruit in the form of a check yesterday in my affliction. Hallelujah. So I'm starting to learn not to complain too much,
yeah.
You know, and just thank God, you know, thank God, because all of that Reverend Hutchison from Future Hope Apprenticeship Program where I work, he says that's contamination. So we can't have doubt. We can't have worry. Mm-hmm. We can't, because those things affect our faith.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I also want to thank God for you and all that you do, because you don't only have a prayer line, but you go out, you visit the sick with a group of women. And you also have pastors, too, that come and pour into your ministry as well, right?
Yeah. On Sunday, we just go, I mean, los domingos.
Sunday.
Nosotros vamos a ministrar después del servicio de León de Judá.
We go and minister after services.
Visitamos gente que, por ejemplo, nos llaman y nos dicen que quiere que vayamos a orar a su casa.
And they ask for prayer, so we go to their homes.
Y nosotros también visitamos gente que sabemos que necesitan.
And we also visit people that are in need.
Llegamos de sorpresa.
And we come by surprise.
Yes. Y cuando llegamos así, a veces tuvimos la semana pasada, se aceptaron al Señor dos personas.
Last week, we surprised somebody and two people were saved. Glory to God.
El mes pasado fue una pareja.
And last month it was a couple.
Que estoy ministrando hace como más de un mes.
And I've been ministering to them for more than a month.
Supuso tuvo una situación que ellos son inmigrantes.
Her husband had a situation, they're immigrants.
Él tuvo preso por 8 días.
And he was in jail for 8 days.
Y estuvimos orando por él. Ella se entró a la línea a orar por él también.
And we were praying for him, and his wife came on the line as well.
Y él cuenta que llegó inmigración.
And he talks about how immigration came.
Inmigración se llevó un grupo de gente.
And took a group of people.
Le preguntó a él que si él tenía papeles.
And they asked him if he had his papers.
Él dijo que no.
He said no.
Y ellos dijeron que iban a regresar por él.
And they said they were going to come back for him.
Y no regresaron.
And they didn't come back. Hallelujah.
Y él está impresionado, y él recibió al Señor por.
And he received the Lord.
Dentro de la cárcel.
In jail.
Él conoció un muchacho portugués.
He met a Portugal guy.
A mí el Señor le puso esa persona ahí porque esa persona conoce del Señor.
The Lord put him there because he knew the Lord.
Y ahí el Señor trató con él.
And the Lord started dealing with him.
Él salió de esa cárcel bien diferente, otra persona.
He came out of the jail a different person.
Yeah. Glory to God. El Señor está tratando con esta pareja, la estoy ministrando.
And the Lord is dealing with them, and I'm able to minister to them. Glory to God. Glory.
Y eso es lo que hacemos los domingos. Esto salimos después del servicio.
That's what we do.
Cuando nosotros
Sundays.
Recibimos.
When we receive.
Nosotros vamos a llevar a esas personas que necesitan.
And we give to the needy.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. Thank if you. You have a prayer request. Or if you have anything that you would like to, if you would like to know the Lord,
yes,
and be led, mm-hmm. all you have to do is repent of, because we're all sinners, we all fall short.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to confess with our mouth, Jesus Christ is our Lord.
Amen.
And receive him as our Lord. I'm sorry.
Y dice la palabra
mm-hmm. que, and the word says,
que nosotros somos ¿cómo se llama? Creación de Dios.
We are created
hasta que no confesemos con nuestra boca.
And until we confess with our mouth.
Nosotros no venimos siendo hijos de Dios.
We don't become children of God.
Yo sé que mucha gente dice yo soy hija de Dios, pero hasta que usted no confiese que usted recibe al Señor como Señor y Salvador.
But until you confess that
you receive.
With your mouth, mm-hmm. that you receive the Lord.
No viene siendo hijo de Dios.
You're not a child of God. So it's very important to confess. I think that's in Romans 9.
Romanos 9.
And 10. Sí. Mm-hmm. Ooh, Jesus, brighten my eyes. I'm looking through my Bible right now to find.
También le puedo el número de la cadena, pues si quieren.
Oh, yes.
¿Alguien te interesado entrar?
The line, yes, the line number.
605. ¿Tú lo puedes decir? 605-781-0005. It's a pin number that you had to pull when you go into the line. It's 5A 1562.
Amen. Glory to God.
Yeah.
So it's 781-605.
No. No, 605.
605.
Mm-hmm.
781. Okay, 781-00-005.
And then the PIN number is 581562.
Okay, and the PIN is 581562. Okay, great. Okay, so yes, in Romans 9, I think in 10, this is what you were saying. Not only that, oh, wait a minute, am I in the right? Was it Romans 10 and 9? Creo que es 19, ¿verdad?
No me acuerdo donde lo dice, pero ya sé que la palabra dice.
Mm-hmm. For it is with your heart, it's Romans 10:9.
Mm-hmm.
For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. So what you're saying, yes,
yeah.
We have to say it out loud with our mouth.
Yes.
I know at 6 o'clock at Greater Love Tabernacle, they do have a prayer line as well. And the conference call number for you to get in at 6 a.m. This is Monday through Friday, is 712-432-0111. And the code is 150100#. And they like for people to mute their phones because there's an elder that actually does the praying. And then we do have a time for praise and worship together every half an hour. So that's from 6 to 7, the Greater Love Tabernacle prayer line, 712-432-0111. And the code is 150100. And remember to mute your phones. But I think it's very important that we live by the word of God. No
Amen.
Matter what anybody
uh-huh.
says, read your word for yourself.
Yeah.
And please let it be King James, maybe, or New King James Version. And Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John were my best friends when I first got saved. Mm. And if you want to know who you are, Ephesians is a good book to read, and Colossians. But knowing the word of God is very important because that's what renews your mind and that's what transforms you. We don't do it. The Holy Spirit does, and the Holy Spirit lives in the word of God.
Amen.
Yes. And we're going to take a break right now, and we'll be right back after this. Thank you for listening.
We're here for you, and we give. To the one who is worthy, our hearts are ready, Lord. Come on, let's shout it out. We're here for you. Hey, come on, everybody. Lift your voice tonight. If you know that you're here for the Lord, sing on. I worship, all we can give is for you. We're here for you.
We're here for you.
For you.
For you.
And nobody else, Jesus, for you.
For you.
Come on, everybody, we dance.
We dance.
Come on, we sing.
We sing.
And we worship.
We worship.
You are beautiful, King. We're here for you. We give. We give you our hearts tonight, Jesus.
Everything.
To the one who is worthy.
again. And again you're there, Lord.
And again
I reach out.
And again
you hold me. You console me once more.
Listening to WBPG LP 102.9 FM radio. We are located at 670 Washington Street in Dorchester, Massachusetts. Our zip code is 02124. Our phone number is 617-282-0685. 617-282-0685.
The views and opinions expressed by the following paid program are those of the program producers, and they do not reflect the views and opinion of
Global Ministries Christian Church, its staff, or management.
A Believer's Walk of Faith is paid for by Bill Winston Ministries.
Okay, great. And thank you so much for listening. My name is Patty Lee, your host, and this program is based on Psalm 119:72, Fruitful in Your Affliction. I'm actually a host as well on Boston Neighborhood Network, and I will have a live show February 18th at 5:30. You can also check me out on YouTube. I have my own channel, Patty Lee TV, and I would love for you to subscribe and follow me there. And you can see a lot of the work that I have done in studio, what my focuses are, and just trying to show what God is doing for, Amen. You know, in our community, because we're so rich. We have so much in the kingdom of God, and sometimes we don't know the beautiful resources that we have all around us. And but another resource, and I think is so invaluable, is the resource of prayer, right? What can we do without prayer? What can we do without knowing the word of God? We can do nothing, you know. So I praise God for what you're doing. And the ministry that you have of the prayer line at 8 is actually a 7 days a week.
Yes.
5 a.m. 1 p.m.
Actually, 5 to 6.
5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Mm-hmm.
3 to 4.
3 a.m. to 4 a.m.
Yeah.
1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Mm-hmm. And then you have a Bible study at 8 p.m.
At 8 p.m. Actually, nosotros oramos.
We pray.
Y también estudiamos la palabra.
And we also study the word of God.
Ahora mismo estamos en Mateo.
Right now we're in Matthew.
En el libro de Mateo.
And we're in the book of Matthew.
Yeah. Y estudiamos y tenemos una persona que nosotros leemos, otra persona lo explica. Y si alguien tiene alguna pregunta de lo que leímos o qué entendió de la palabra, que quisiera que discutiéramos.
Okay. And so one person will read, another person will have an explanation of the reading, and then if somebody's given a revelation or they would like to discuss the word, we go into discussion.
Que le expliquemos más a fondo de lo que.
So we explain more deeply what the scriptures.
Porque
mean.
Es muy importante leer la palabra, porque it's la palabra es la misma, la palabra de Dios. O sea, Él nos habla a través de la palabra.
Uh-huh. The word of God is so important because it is His word, mm-hmm. and this is how He speaks to us.
Yes. Y tenemos que entenderla porque con la palabra el Señor nos va transformando.
And we have to understand because this is what transforms us.
Yeah. Es muy importante.
It's very important.
Amen.
So again, the number is
605-605-781-781-0005. Y el code, el número del code number es 5.
The code is
5-8-1-5-1-5-6-2. Yeah.
Pound. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So thank you so much for always having a place and a space that we can meet. And I know we also have little gatherings as well. Yes. And we get together and we fellowship. And I know you blessed us. It had to be the 6th of November. I won't forget. And the prophet of God came, and he's a pastor as well, and had a beautiful testimony of just how God transformed and renewed his life, healed him, and is using him in such a mighty way. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Él tiene un precioso testimonio que transforma vidas.
He has a beautiful testimony that transforms lives.
Sí, cuando tenemos estas reuniones, usualmente invitamos a alguien o...
When we usually have our meetings or reunions or fellowship times,
yes.
We do, Anna invites people. She is so beautiful. She brought him from Santo Domingo.
Yeah.
Powerful guy. Wow, powerful guy. And spoke to us. You know, I mean, and really kind of ushered us into, the Lord used him to usher us into another place.
Yes.
Sometimes we don't want to go, and he's like, I'm going to push you anyway. Like Ezekiel, right? He catapulted him into the place of the dry bones to speak and understand what his authority was. Mm-hmm. You know, it doesn't look good, but I'm not asking you to look at what it looks like. Speak to it, you know, so... Yeah, he brought this dry bone alive. Thank you so much. I appreciate you so much. Thank you for all that you do. And I appreciate all the women that come on the line as well to agree and be in one accord about heart issues, our children, our families, our churches.
Oramos unos por los otros también. De la cadena oramos unas por las otras porque es muy importante cubrirse con la unas a otras con la oración.
And we also pray one for the other that are on the line because it's very important to have that covering.
Yes.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. And I'm thinking of just beautiful women of God and how they teach me too to enter into the presence of the Lord and to seek him. Seek him no matter what, and to thank him no matter what. And I was telling somebody this morning, I'm so glad I don't look like what I've been through, because I would have looked like roadkill, you know, and everybody else would have threw me back.
Mm-hmm.
But my God, you know, I'm his child.
God is beautiful.
He's so. And he loves all of us. You know, I don't know if people know, but I lost a son in 2013.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he was preparing me for that for a long time.
Yeah.
And so that I could endure that affliction. But you were going to say something. Go on.
No, yo lo que iba a decir era que, I just going to say, que el Padre dice que si nuestro Padre es terrenal, nos da todo lo que pidamos. ¿Cuánto más nuestro Padre Celestial?
Earthly will give us all that we ask. How much more our Father in Heaven wouldn't give us.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That is so
Y es muy
beautiful.
Importante la oración It's al Padre.
Prayer is very important. And I think
To the Father.
To the Father. Yes. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think that even when I lost my son, I didn't want to be bothered with anybody, you know, and I was in so much pain, and I was like just wanting to disconnect because I felt like nobody could really understand.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to have my conversation with God, you know, and I did that, you know, and sometimes I would scream at the top of my lungs, you know, but that's okay. My God can take that, you know, and sometimes just cry. That God can take that, you know, and some people say, oh, well, don't do this and don't do this. You know what? You know your relationship with God and he knows you because he made you.
Yes.
So if you're mad, be mad. If you're sad, cry, be sad. He gave you those emotions, everything. He knit you together in your mother's womb.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And he's not going to leave you.
No, and I felt standing like, there next to you.
I felt like I was alone. I really did. Mm-hmm. But you know what? I know now that I look at it, I know I wasn't, because mm-hmm. I would have been out of my mind, you know, and doing things that I shouldn't do, mm-hmm. you know. And even that, like I was talking to a sister yesterday, and she was like, oh, and she was condemning herself. And I was like, you know what? That's not of our Father. You know, okay, say I confess it and move on, because God has some great things for you to do.
Yes.
And you have to continue to look at him. Mm-hmm. See, the enemy is throwing everything at us. Everything. He knows our weaknesses. Mm-hmm. He's so good. 24/7, he's after the children of God. But, you know, we have to focus on God. And just like when I read that Psalm 68, let my God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Listen, just stay right there for half an hour. Let my God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let my God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let my God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Never to gather again in the name of Jesus. See, I am very emotional, and that's where I need to go in warfare. Right there in that emotion. He hears my heart cry. He hears my prayer. See, I'm a female, so we get all emotional and everything. So I gotta learn, okay, this is how my cry to you, God, right now. He isn't like, oh, Patty just yelled, let my God, you know, he's not, you know, moved by not. That.
No.
If that's what I gotta do, that's what I gotta do to get my way through this. If I have to praise him, and sometimes I know I probably look ridiculous to people, right, in church, because I be jumping, girl, I don't know what God is doing in my life. I just got to praise him, Anna, because I am now, like, completely free. He broke some things off of me, and he was showing some things, and so, like, now it's like, woo, I'm going to just go with it. And I got to praise him because I know what he got me through, you know, and he knows, you know. So it's so intimate that nobody can tell you your walk and talk with God. You know, they can kind of guide you and read your word and pray, and, you know, but he made all those emotions. You're not supposed to hold on to pain. Let it go. Cry. Yes. Oh, God, you know, are you seeing? Are you watching? Go on, Anna.
Cuando pensamos que el Señor no está ahí.
When we think that the Lord isn't there.
Él está bien cerca de ti.
That's where he's closest.
Que tú dijiste ahorita que tú te sentías sola. No te sentías.
That I felt by myself. Yeah. That's what I just said.
Pues ahí está el Señor bien cerca de ti.
That's where
no
the
lo
Lord
sentimos.
Is very close.
Porque estamos enfocados en el dolor. En la tristeza, estamos enfocados en lo que estamos
pain,
pasando.
Affliction, what we're going through.
Yes. Y el Señor está más cerca de ti.
And that's when he's closest to you.
Y a veces te lleva cargada y no lo sentimos porque estamos tan enfocados en el dolor y en la tristeza.
And we have so much like burden that we have so much
pain,
sadness and depression that we don't feel that he's there.
Él está ahí.
But he's right there.
Y a veces te tiene abrazada y no lo sentimos.
And sometimes he might even be embracing you.
Yes.
And you don't even feel him.
Because estás enfocada en tu dolor.
Because you're focused on your pain.
Cuando yo le recomiendo que cuando nos sentamos tristes, que sentamos que ya vamos a deprimirnos, alaba
sad,
a Dios, alábalo.
When you're depressed,
y alaba al Señor. Just praise him and you're going to see cuántas cosas él va a hacer.
You're going to see how many things the Lord is going to do.
Yeah.
Amen.
Le recomiendo que solamente, que no se enfoquen en el dolor ni en la tristeza. Todo vamos a pasar por eso. Y esto es Señor preparándonos.
He's preparing us. This is a way of him preparing us.
Yeah. Entonces no nos enfoquemos en el dolor, sino en lo que Dios puede hacer a través de ese dolor.
We have to look at what he's going to do through that pain.
Yeah.
There is purpose in the pain.
Yes,
and
el propósito.
I didn't realize that because I was so mad. I was like, God, how much more you want me to suffer? I don't want to suffer no more. I don't want to go. And he's like, she's still complaining. And then I figured it out. Oh, let me stop complaining. And let me just praise my way through.
Amen.
And say, thank you, God. Thank you, thank you, thank you for breaking the yokes. Thank you for just having me here. Thank you for another day. Thank you for every platform. Thank you for just every affliction. Because if I hadn't been through that, I wouldn't have made it to here and been in kind of my right mind. No, sir, because I know some people might beg to differ, but that's okay. I need my joy. Yes. And I know in his presence, there is fullness of joy, you know, and there's nothing like that. And that's what brings his presence. Mm-hmm. Like when two or more are gathered in his name, he's there.
Yes.
You know, so that's awesome. So he's here right now with us. Amen. If you have a prayer request, you can call 617-282-0685. We would love to pray with you and agree with you. And I just think this is just an awesome time, you know, yes, of God and what he's going to do. Sometimes, like, when we read the Bible, too, and the famines, mm-hmm, and when they were going through stuff, that's when God showed up mightily, you know, and he turned it all around. And in the desert places, he made streams. Mm-hmm. And famines, that's when he made so much abundance to his people that have faith and really believed in him.
Amen.
You know? Or he might have used one or two or three, but I know there's more believers than that. I see so many people praying and believing God, you know, for miraculous mm-hmm things. And there are miraculous things happening now, you know, and I just love it. But I don't know. I want to acknowledge Anna's Pro Cleaning services. They're just so awesome to have in part sponsored this program. And they have over 10 years of experience in a wide range of maintenance, cleaning projects for commercial spaces, daycares, industries, landscaping, medical offices, residential homes, construction, and they also do snow removal. So they also specialize in repair projects, carpentry, plumbing, and painting. And they have high standards, and they have all the equipment and tools necessary to do the job. And I thank God for Anna Earl. You know, they're beautiful people of God. And their number is 781-251-0700. I apologize. I'm having some technical things that we have to work through here at Boston Praise Radio and TV, but he's bringing us to higher levels in order to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ throughout Boston, throughout New England. And I just praise God for Mohasa as well, for always hooking my hair up. She's conveniently located at 1855 Washington Street in Boston South End. That's almost like at the corner of Washington Street and Mass Ave. And she does, she really hooks it up. She really does. And I want to go to some music, and I will come right back. I just need to clear my throat. Thank you. We won't move. And you don't come. We won't move. We're desperate. We need you.
Desperate, Lord. Say it one more time, one more time. we all move. Desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. You don't come, we won't move. Desperate. So we dance and we sing and we worship. You are King. We're here for you. We give everything to who? To the one who is worthy. Oh, that's so sweet. Say that again. To the one who is worthy. To the one who is worthy. Our hearts are ready, Lord. Do a new thing, God. Say it again. To the one who is worthy. Our hearts are ready, Lord. Say it one more time, one more time. To the one.
And this is Patty Lee again, here with Anna Cardona from Lion of Judah. And I'd just like to thank everybody for listening and watching. We would like to close out with prayer. So, Sister Anna, if you want to pray in Spanish, and then I'll pray in English.
Okay. Señor, te damos gracias una vez más, Padre amado, por este tiempo.
Thank you.
Te doy gracias por... por este tiempo que me ha permitido estar aquí, Señor, Padre, orando por las personas que están escuchando en esta hora, Señor. Yo te pido que usted toque a cada persona, cada oyente, Padre amado, que está en esta línea, Señor, escuchando. Te pido, Señor, que usted conoce la necesidad de cada una de estas personas, Padre amado. Si necesitan sanidad, Señor, que usted envíe su palabra de sanidad, Señor, sobre esas vidas que están escuchando. Si necesitan, Señor, provisión de comida, dinero, Señor, trabajo, apartamento, cualquier necesidad, Padre amado, que usted sea glorificándote, Señor, tomando el dominio y control, Señor, Padre, de cada oyente, Señor, que estuvo en este momento escuchando tu palabra, escuchando, Señor, Padre, y que si no ha hecho la confesión de fe, Padre amado, que usted ponga ese deseo, ese anhelo de confesar con su boca que usted es el Señor, que sin usted nada es, nada puede hacer, Señor, que te reciba como Señor y Salvador, que haga, Señor, esa confesión, Padre, que te invite a entrar a su corazón, Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, Padre, para que usted sea entrando a su corazón y sea dirigiéndolo en todo momento, en todo tiempo. Padre, te pido, Señor, que usted tome el dominio y control de cada vida, cada alma, Señor, que estas almas son de salvación, Padre, y que puedan venir a ti con paso gigante, Señor. Tome el dominio y glorifícate de manera especial, Señor. Manifiesta tu gloria y tu poder, Señor, Padre amado, sobre las vidas. En el nombre de Jesús te lo rogamos, te lo suplicamos, Señor Padre, a quien damos toda gloria, Señor. Mira los jóvenes, las prostitutas, los homosexuales, Señor, los drogadictos, los jóvenes, Señor. Si hay algún joven esta hora que el enemigo le está diciendo que se quite la vida, Padre, reprendemos en el nombre de Jesús y declaramos vida. Declaramos vida en el nombre de Jesús, Padre. Declaramos vida, Señor, Padre. Usted nunca llega tarde, usted llega a tiempo, Señor. Reprendemos toda obra del enemigo, Señor, Padre. Padre, glorifícate en los jóvenes, Señor. Quita toda ira, todo enojo, Señor, todo lo que no le pertenece, Padre. Manifiesta tu gloria, Señor, y tráelos a ti con lazos de amor. Padre, te damos la gloria y la honra, Señor, en el nombre de Jesús. Padre amado, que sea usted obrando y glorificándote de manera especial, Señor, en esta vida, a quien damos toda gloria y toda honra, Señor. Gracias por lo que estás haciendo y seguirás haciendo. En el nombre de Jesús, amén. Y amén.
Amen, amen. Father God, I just like to thank you for all those that are listening right now, Father God. I thank you that your richest blessing would rest on them right now in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father God, for every man or woman, every child, Father God, that has had a loss, Father God, of a son, of a daughter, Father God, of a sibling, oh God, of a nephew or a niece, oh God, or anyone that has had any kind of loss, Father God, that their life has been taken, Father God, short, in the name of Jesus, comfort them. Comfort them like only you can, oh God. That the peace that surpasses human understanding be released and go abide with them now in the name of Jesus. We speak peace be still to the seabed of their emotions. Peace be still to their minds, to their thought, the seabed of their thoughts in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, we thank you for your peace, God. Peace be still in their homes. Peace be still in their homes, Father God. I thank you for their children, Father God. Cover them in the blood of Jesus Christ, from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. And we declare, Father God, that they will know you, Father God. That they will know your word, Father God. That they will bind them around their necks, Father God. Your statutes. And that, Father God, that they would have everything, Father God, supplied to them. According to your riches and glory, that there would be no lack, Father God. I speak, Father God, to the fatherless, Father God. And I thank you for them, oh God. I lift them up to you.
Yes.
I lift them up to you, oh God. You are their father, Father God, that they would know, Father God, they have a perfect father in you.
Amen, Father.
They have a perfect father in you, Father God. That you never turn away. Let them know who you are as Father.
Yes, Lord.
Let them know, Father God, who you are. I thank you, Father God, for the babies, Father God, the orphans, Father, that don't have parents, Father God. I thank you, Father, that you will put, Father, spiritual parents around them to train them up in the fear and admonition of you, oh God. I thank you. You said, don't let the babies be put away from you, Father God. It is commanded that we let them know who you are and whose they are, Father God. I thank you, Father God, that your hand will just be stretched on the bodies, Father God, of anybody that's ailing right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
And we command pain right now to leave in the name of Jesus. You have to cease and desist right now in the name of Jesus in the body of Christ. And we thank you, Father God, for your healing virtue, oh God. Your healing virtue over these airwaves in the name of Jesus. We thank you for these airwaves, oh God. Thank you for the airwaves, Father God. Thank you. We declare the blood of Jesus over these airwaves in Boston in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the risen King.
Amen.
We thank you, Father God, that he died, but he rose with all power in his hands, Father God.
Yes,
we
Lord.
Thank you for that power, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you that we have risen, oh God. We are risen with you, oh God.
Amen, Lord.
We thank you for that awesome privilege and honor, oh God. We thank you. We thank you for the Holy Spirit with power.
Father, hallelujah.
We thank you for the Holy Spirit with power, oh God. We thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. Have your way.
Hallelujah, Father Lord.
Have your way and your will, oh God.
Yes.
We thank you, Father God, for a broken church.
Yes.
We thank you that you would be glorified, that it wouldn't be us,
you are
but
holy,
it would
holy,
be you, Father,
holy,
that would
Father,
be glorified
Lord.
In and through everything that we do, oh God, for your kingdom and for your Christ.
In the
and
name
we thank
of
you,
Jesus,
Father
Lord.
God, for the blood of Jesus
thank you,
that
Lord.
Covers us,
yes.
That covers everything that we do.
Thank
that
you,
goes
Lord.
Against every enemy of God right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you, God. We thank you that you be exalted, Father God. We thank
Lord.
You, Father God, that is done. And
in
we
the
bless
name
you,
of
oh
Jesus,
God.
Lord.
And we thank you, Father God, for this time.
Thank you,
Father,
yes.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Glory to the name. Glory to your name.
In Jesus' name. And I thank you once again. My name is Patty Lee. I am host of this program, Fruitful in Your in My Affliction. And I thank God for Sister Ana Cardona.
Thank you
from
for inviting
me. León de Judá. Tengo como una papa en la boca. Sorry. And I thank God for her and her ministry, the prayer ministry. And if you'd like to check out any of my programs, you could do that on YouTube, Patty Lee TV. And I am signing off from 102.9 FM Radio, Boston Praise Radio and TV. God bless you.
Amen.